Hi, welcome to the show. Got a bit of a confession to make. Haven't actually written an ending to this episode. It's fine though, I mean, does a story really have to have a beginning, a middle and an ending?
Of course it does, Noel. That's the definition of a story.
No, this show didn't have an ending. Would you be bothered?
What show?
This show. The show we're making now, for television. Seen the cameras?
Put me down as a maybe.
See, people are pretty laid back around here. No one cares whether there's an ending or not.
No, there's no ending. There's no ending. I've looked everywhere, there is no ending.
Oh, calm down, Andy.
But why have you not written an ending?
Well, you know, I was quite tired, plus I had a stitch.
But what about the people who watch this show? The viewers?
What, Terry?
Yes, Terry.
He'll be alright. He doesn't mind whether there's an ending or not.
Have you heard of the butterfly effect?
Not sure.
A butterfly flaps its wings in Brazil, causing a hurricane in China.
I have heard of that. I love that, actually.
Due to my calculations, if you don't write an ending to the show, Terry, our only viewer, will be killed by an asteroid. In simple terms, Noel, you are the butterfly.
Well, that's no good, because I hate butterflies. They're so pretentious. I prefer moths, you know, like 70s butterflies. Quite tatty and corduroy.
Noel, I don't think you've understood the gravity of the situation. This is not a game of insect top trumps.
Isn't it?
No!
Right, so if I don't write an ending to the show, Terry, our only viewer, is going to be killed by an asteroid.
Yes.
Can't believe it. Terry can't die. Now I love Terry. And he's stuck with me through thick and thin. Remember the DVD signing? Terry!
Hey! All right, Noel.
I knew you'd be first.
Hey!
Oh, brilliant. There you go, mate.
Oh, brilliant.
Best show ever. See you, Terry. Who should I make this out to?
Vladimir.
Didn't know he had any fans in Russia.
Yeah, there's loads.
There you go, Vladimir.
Ah, cheers, now, but best show ever. Hi there, my name's Zeus. Can I have a DVD sign up for my wife, please? She's called Lucy.
Look, Terry, you don't have to do this. It's all right.
Listen, though, I've got a bag full of disguises and a truck outside. I am not leaving this shop until all of these DVDs have been paid for and signed.
Terry, I love you.
Best show ever.
I can't believe he's going to die.
He doesn't have to die. Just write an ending, why don't you?
Exactly.
I can't write anymore.
Why not?
Got a fantasy block.
Fantasy block? What the hell is fantasy block?
It's not a joke for everyone to have a little chuckle at. It's a weird strain of writer's block. Stops you having fantastical ideas.
You've made that up, Noel.
The thing about fantasy block is, it's not that you can't write anything. It's just that you can only write factual stuff. I've tried to write an ending for the show 3 times now. All I've come up with is these car manuals. The Vauxhall Viva one's a treat. And these pamphlets for the local church on Jesus. Although they are borderline fantasy, thinking about it.
Jesus Christ, Terry is doomed.
Fantasy block, it's psychological, isn't it? It's like sexy times. If you think about it too much, you can't get any crunch in your biscuits. We've all suffered from soft chocolate now. Oh, floppy ball burn.
I know it's psychological. What am I going to do about it?
Oh, my friend Salvador Dali once had fantasy block.
Really?
Yes, for 2 years he could have no fantastical ideas.
So what happened to him?
He was forced to become a rent boy, and he eventually contracted syphilis of the eyes, nose, and brain.
Oh. Brilliant. Okay, well, see you all at Terry's funeral. Smooth, you sort out a reef, yeah? Alright, so what is Tony about? I need to have a word with him.
Now he's popped to Pret, hasn't he? You know, we take turns. He's gone to get me my crayfish salad.
He's a vegan, isn't he?
He's so boring with food, it makes it a nightmare in here. You can't get anything.
He likes a bit of tofu, doesn't he?
I don't... what are the constituent parts of tofu?
It's a weird colour, isn't it, tofu?
Well, it's
light grey.
I don't know what it is. show me the person who can tell me what the fuck tofu is, I'll give him a medal. Because no one knows what it is. It's just a name.
It's like a shadow.
Anyway, what can I do you for?
Yeah, I've got a bit of a problem, actually. I haven't written an ending to my show.
Is that a problem? I mean, with all due respect, do any of them have endings? They kind of peter out.
It's not that. It's just that, you know, if I don't write an ending, Terry, our only viewer, is going to get killed by an asteroid.
Right. In which case, maybe write an ending.
Yeah, it's not that simple, is it, Todd?
Right.
It's not that simple.
Is
I mean,
it not?
I've got fantasy block.
Fantasy block.
I can't write an ending.
Right. Well, I had a very similar problem with Chesney Hawkes back in the day. He had melody block.
Melody block?
Melody block for 21 brutal years. And I'll say to you exactly the same thing I said to him. Put a face to it. Yeah?
Put a face to it?
Put a face to it, Ches. If you can see it, then you can beat it. Visualize it. What kind of fellow are we dealing with? Draw a picture of it. Then it exists. Then you can beat it.
Do you know what? That's quite a good idea.
Yes, well, thank you.
You've been really helpful. Thanks, Todd.
Just think of it as advice from a wise, old, hammerhead shark music producer to a slightly younger, backward man, such as yourself.
I've got to go.
Yes, you do.
Well, they ran out of crayfish, so I had to get you a cheese sandwich.
Oh, for God. Did you at least get some crisps?
Got you some vegetable chips.
Oh, those aren't crisps. They are not crisps.
I could rustle up a sort of...
Don't say it.
Tofu burrito.
No.
No?
Not to... The day you can tell me what tofu is, I will eat it. What is it? What's it made from?
Miracles.
Fuck that noise.
Okay. Right, Andy. I'm going to describe my fantasy block, yeah, and you're going to visualise it.
Okay, I am ready. Describe.
Okay, right. Fantasy block. He's quite big, yeah? He's quite rotund, yeah? But he looks quite cool, he's quite stylish. A bit like a Lee Bowery creation.
This is good.
Although he's big, he's got sort of feminine boots on, sort of red feminine boots. And he moves very gracefully, very light on his feet.
Yeah, I went out with a guy like that in Hamburg. A sort of chubby, fashionable man, but he had amazing boots, but turned out to be a dick.
Was that before or after we went out?
There was a little overlap.
A small overlap? All right, he's got sort of like, I thought of something, he's got sort of pants made out of council tax bills, yeah? And he's got syringes for eyes. Oh, quite sinister. And he's got a designer's handbag, a lady's handbag. And inside it, if you open up and look inside, you can just see two egg sandwiches and an eviction notice.
Well, no, I cannot draw inside a handbag.
Sorry.
Quite fancy an egg sandwich.
That's great. Thing is, right, he's got two golden hammers, yeah? And this is the important bit. And he uses them to smash down my fantastical ideas. Whoa! Poo-poo!
What a chunky bastard.
You're not wrong.
Is this him?
Yeah, that's him. That's him, all right. That's ridiculous.
No, what's wrong?
No, it's just, you know, Todd said that if I visualise my fantasy block, you know, if I put a face to it, it would exist.
Oh my God, Noel! I think he does exist. Either that or it's my ex-boyfriend.
Imagine a mouse with rulers for legs, measuring stuff as he runs.
No!
Imagine if you could get religious cordial, it'd taste the hymns.
No!
Imagine looking down at your penis, but it's an Indian man's finger.
No!
Oh my God. I didn't think he was going to be so big.
Oi, mate! Stop blocking all my fantastical ideas. I need those. They're all plausible endings.
Fee, fi, fo, bum. I smell the fantastical ideas of an Englishman!
Yeah, great. Good for you. I don't think you understand. I put a face to you, which means you exist. Which means I can destroy you, leaving me free to write an ending to the show, so I can save Terry, our only viewer, from being destroyed by an asteroid. Who wrote this show? Couldn't it be me? I've got a fantasy block.
No!
Imagine being interfered with by a cockerel with no eyes. Who would you turn to?
No!
Imagine if you could taste your dreams.
No!
Imagine rolling up your shadow and inserting it into your dad's anus.
No!
Imagine a motorbike made of jealousy.
I mean, look at him out there, smashing up my fantastical ideas. It's not on. I'd have to get in touch with the authorities.
Smooth.
Can you go and get get New York Cop?
It's my lunch break.
All right, I've taken care of that. Here's your little packed lunch.
What's in this?
Ants.
An ant sandwich?
Yeah, with a bit of piccalilli.
Is that what you think I eat?
Well, you're an anteater, aren't you?
Yeah, I've told you before, I'm mixed race. My mum's an anteater, my dad's a man.
No matter how many times you tell me that, I can never fully get my head around it. And tell New York Cop to come and arrest Fancy Block. Tell him to bring some guns.
Yes, and a teaser for his balls.
Cheese toasty out here. I am starving. No coriander, my friend. I repeat, no coriander. Otherwise, I'll have you publicly flogged.
All right, Raymond.
Smooth. Have a seat. You like the reggae music, Smooth? The deep sounds of the Rasta folk?
I like Lee Scratch Perry.
Ah, Lee Scratch Perry and the Upsetters. I love the Rastas, those willowy men clouded in a puff of doobie smoke. How can I help you, my young violet friend?
I'm here on behalf of Noah. He needs your help.
Jesus, what is it this time?
There's a big monster called Fantasy Block.
A big monster called Fantasy Block. And?
He's stopping Noah having any fantastical ideas.
So what does he want me to do about it?
He wants you to arrest it. Or shoot it in the face.
I cannot do that. I'm rape and murder. You know that's smooth. Besides, it's good that someone's stopping Noah having fantastical ideas.
Why?
Well, these fantasy people wandering around in a daydream. They're a threat to society, Smooth. Let me give you an example of that. They make my job a lot harder. Hey, you! You pay your taxes!
Oh, I can't. I'm making a canoe out of vultures.
A canoe out of vultures? What is this shit? Hooper, these fantasy people wandering around in a daydream, making canoes out of vultures. What are they, Hooper?
They're a threat to society.
You're damn right they're a threat to society.
So that's a no then, is it?
Yeah, it's a no.
What if I was to ask you again? But maybe this time slip a little something your way.
What is this, Smooth?
It's an ant sandwich.
An ant sandwich? Are you trying to bribe an officer of the law with an insect baguette?
Not really, I just didn't want it.
Okay, Smooth. We've been friends a long time, so I'm gonna let this sorry incident pass. But you better leave this office right now and think about what you just did and the moral implications of that thing and the position you put me in.
All right.
You made a mess of our relationship. Hoopa, what about the reggae again? You pumped that into me. Okay, let's see what's going on with the ant sandwich.
Gracious.
Imagine bread in the shape of a question mark. Then you could make what sandwiches?
No!
Imagine wearing a hat under your own hair.
No!
Imagine your hands are so soft you try and catch a bubble and your hands burst.
No!
Imagine moth poke. No! Imagine a cow. No! Yeah, but yeah, imagine. No! Imagine. No! Imagine a milkshake, Al-Qaeda flavour.
No!
Where's New York Cop?
He's not coming.
Why not?
He said you're a threat to society.
Threat to society? Do you hear that? I'm a threat to society. Might start carrying a blade around in there.
Noel, what about Terry?
Yeah, that's a good point. What about Terry?
Alright, guys.
Terry?
It's Terry.
Hi, mate, how are you?
Alright.
Muffin?
Nah, you're alright. Listen, I've just been watching the show. It is brilliant.
You're on it now.
Yeah, I suppose I am. Hey, Noel, is it alright if I say hello to Julie, who works with me at the garden centre?
Yeah, yeah, of course. Who's that? Come on there.
Alright. Alright, Julie!
She doesn't watch the show. Of course not, you're our only viewer.
Yeah, she hates it. Hey, listen, I just thought I'd come down, because I know you've all been working really hard trying to beat Fantasy Block and write an ending to the show so I don't get killed by an asteroid.
Of course we are, Terry. I mean, we love you. We don't need to die.
Oh, thanks. But listen, just don't beat yourself up about it. No, I won't hold it against you. So I love you guys, and I love this show.
Terry, that is so brave. So hot for you right now.
Thanks. Thing is, you see, Noel, getting hit by an asteroid, that's a pretty fantastical way to go. Imagine my gravestone. Terry, killed by an asteroid. Imagine, that's perfect. It's like something out of one of your shows, isn't it, Noel? It's that kind of thing. So, anyway, I better dash.
Oh, come on, Terry, you can stay for a bit.
No, I borrowed my brother's van to get here and he needs it for work in the morning.
Fair enough.
All right. See ya.
Bye, Terry.
Bye. Bye, Terry. Oh, well, one other thing. I don't mean to speak out of turn. Obviously, this is entirely up to you, but if you did want to save me, why not ask Fancy Man to help? Hey, Fancy Man, Fancy Man.
Oh, you do it better than me.
Hey, best show ever.
Bye, Terry.
See you, Terry.
Bye, Terry.
Thanks for coming, Terry.
Bye.
Terry, see ya.
Oh, Terry's adorable.
I know, me too. People are bound to die have such a sexy glow to them.
I know. The doomed man often makes my orbs fizz.
Yes, Terry is a very sexy man. But you must phone Fantasy Man before it's too late.
Yeah, all right, I'll do it. What are you going to do?
Sanitize the coffee grinder?
Good thinking. Dolly, do you think you could phone Fantasy Man?
Why me?
Well, it's just that you're a woman, you know, it'd be better coming from you, sort of damsel in distress.
That is so sexist.
It's not sexist. You think he's a knight from the 15th century.
Okay, I'll do it.
Brilliant. Okay, right, but you're going to have to couch it in his own terms, yeah? Keep the dialogue quite medieval. He only usually takes noble quests.
Couch it in his own terms? What is this?
Can you stop being sarcastic just for one moment to do this for me?
Hello, Fancy Man here. Can I help you?
Yeah, hi. It's Princess Dolly, and I'm calling from a castle in Hawaii.
Castle Hawaii. Princess Dolly, how may I assist you, sweet fair maiden?
Well, there is an ogre outside the castle called Fantasy Block.
Fantasy Block? I've never heard of him. What's he doing exactly?
Well, basically, it's just being a total dick.
Don't swear. He hates swearing. Keep it medieval.
I mean, help! He's blocking everyone's fantastical ideas!
Well, we must act fast and stop this mischief maker, dead in his tracks! If he succeeds in blocking all things fantastical, he'll waste no time in moving on to absurdism, and then perhaps whimsy! Soon enough, we'll all be drowning in a sea of facts, drying out on a riverbed of reality! And we certainly can't have that!
So, are you gonna come?
Yes, of course I'll come. I'll have to go through the triangle of destiny.
Look, it's Fantasy Man. He's come through the triangle of destiny.
Yeah, he's come through, all right, but what's he doing exactly?
I'd say he was falling.
I'd say he was more plummeting. Plummeting to a watery grave.
Hang on, there's someone else coming through the Triangle of Destiny.
That's Big Chief Woolabum, Boomalaka Way.
Who?
Big Chief Woolabum, Boomalaka Way.
Where on earth have you two been?
Just got back from Festival.
Festival? That was 2 weeks ago.
Yes.
I see that Arnold 5 has a stunning new pair of Pegasus wings.
Yeah, they're basically giant-sized rave gloves. We bought them off my friend Clive.
Good God, how big is this Clive character?
Same height as me.
Ah, joyful banter. Anyway, on with the business in hand. Namely, destroying one fantasy block.
Oh, he's a big man.
Look at the size of his pen. Right then, Arnold 5, prepare the fantasy cannon. Arnold 5, I know the fancy cannon is essentially your penis, but you have to make it quite so sexual. Right, Big Chief, have you prepared the ammunition?
Yes.
Let's have a look at it. Ah, perfect. Pieces of broken rainbow, fused with the actual shit of Terry Gilliam. If this doesn't work, I'll eat it myself. Let's lock and load. Ah! Chief!
Fee, fi, fo, fum. I see the shit of Terry Gilliam.
It's me, Princess Dolly. I'm so hot for you right now.
Yes, it is rather close, isn't it? Quite a balmy evening. Goodbye!
I've got it. The ending for the show.
Look, everyone, I'm in a canoe made of vultures. We all are. And we've saved Terry.
Thanks, guys. Best show ever.
Terry on the beach in the morning sun lifts up his skirt for the fisherman. Terry does some dancing to lose control. Now he's on the ground as a forward bull. Terry loves fantasy. Oh yeah, he doesn't love reality. Oh no, luxury comedy. Oh yeah, watched by a minority. Oh no, picking up the pieces of his broken life. Staring at the body of his sleeping wife. Goes into the street and he never coming back. Mumbles to himself, I've had enough of that. Terry loves fantasy. Oh yeah, he doesn't like reality. Oh no, fantasy comedy.
Oh yeah, a threat to society.
That's right, a threat to society. Everyone.
This shouldn't be happening.
Oops, I appear to have miscalculated.
Andy!
I'm a fantasy martyr!
I thought that went rather well, Big Chief.
Yes.
Oi! Come on, you two. You've been on there all afternoon.
Please, Clive. Just one more go.
Nah. Enough's enough. Now, can I have my gloves back? I've got a snooker match to referee tonight.